to see the sunny Fairfield.
Respected members of the faculty, I'm very grateful for the knowledge that you have given me, but I'm afraid what I'm looking for can't be found in books.
And Pippin made a promise.
I promise not to waste my life on commonplace, ordinary pursuits. I am going to live a life that's extraordinary. I know there is something... I can't quite find the word for it.
Fulfilling. Something completely fulfilling.
Yes. That's it. Something completely fulfilling. And I'm going to find it. Not exactly sure what I want to do or where I want to go. Everything has its season. Everything has its time. Show me her feast and I'll soon jog you right. Cats fit on the windowsill. Children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Evils belong where they tremble. Evils belong where they can't fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Give for my corner of the sky. Every man has his daydreams. Every man has his club. People like the way dreams have them sticking to the soul. Thunderbirds have the lightning. Nightingales have a song, yeah. Don't you see I want my life to be something more than wrong? Heed us the Lord with the triumph. Heed us the Lord, they have done. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Give for that corner of the sky. Something unseen, destined to stand for something small. But I won't rest until I know I'll have it all. So don't ask where I'm going, just listen when I'm gone. Far away you'll hear me singing softly in the dawn. Rivers belong where they tremble. Eagles belong, they can fly.
A live one.
Yeah! To lead to journey to a spot, exciting, mystic, and exotic journey through our anecdotic review. The royal court of Charles the Great. Enter Charlemagne.
This part is to be played by an actor of enormous power.
Power! 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 Power!
We join Charlemagne amidst his royal council. It has been a long day.
And that is why, sire, I humbly beseech you to reduce my levy of...
Deny! Next!
Oh, great leader, blessed by God, sent to us from heaven to protect us from the infidel.
Oh, not all that bullshit again! What is it?
Sire, due to a famine, my fields are barren.
Deny! Next!
Sire!
Deny!
But sire, I protest, this is unjust and tyrannical.
Take that man away and hang him! Out!
No, wait, out. Sire!
I said
everybody
out!
It's me, Pippin.
Pippin? Pippin! Wait, what are you doing here?
I'm home. I finished school.
Already? Well, how did that go?
Oh, very well, Father. Some of my tutors
good,
say that...
Good, I'm a great believer in education.
And yet, you've become the most powerful man in the world without it.
The most powerful man in the world? What about the Pope?
Oh, I rank you ahead of the Pope, sir.
And I happen to agree with you. Well, Pippin, good to see you.
Father, wait.
You know, we have a library now. Maybe you could find a book or something.
Thank you, but
after all, tomorrow is for you.
But it's still today.
Yes, but for how long, Pippin? You'll see. Sunrise and sunset are similar, but they are not identical.
Father, what does that even mean?
Enter Louis. Pippin's half-brother, and after Pippin, heir to the throne. Addicted to the physical, Louis loves weightlifting. Louis loves wrestling, but most of all, Louis loves Louis!
Ha! Physicals!
Well done, brother.
Of course it was. Did you know this arm slew 20 Frisians last year? It is going to slay even more Visigoths.
You're going to war against the Visigoths?
Uh-huh. That's the next one. And it's going to be a glorious campaign. And, oh, those Visigoth women. I don't mean to shock your bookish sensibility.
I'm only shocked you're interested in women now.
Enter Lestrada. Pippin's stepmother. Crafty. Cunning, calculating, but a warm and wonderful mother, dedicated to gaining the throne for her darling son, Louis.
Louis, guess what mommy has made for you? Surprise!
Oh, thank you, Mother. Think how I shine. Look at it. Isn't it a beauty?
It really is beautiful.
Of course it's beautiful. Louis is a great warrior.
Pisagos!
We are so proud of Louis, aren't we, dear? Oh, my darling, before I forget, the royal treasurer informs me I've somehow overdrawn my allowance account.
You're overdrawn again?
Now, my lord. You know how confused I get about money. After all, I'm just an ordinary housewife and mother. Just like all you housewives and mothers out there.
You know, sometimes I wonder if the fornicating I'm getting is worth the fornicating I'm getting.
Father, I know what I want to do now.
Uh-huh. Oh, good, good.
I want to be a soldier.
Did I?
But, Father, I'm your oldest son. That means I'll be king one day. And fighting wars is an important part of being king, isn't it?
Fighting wars is the most important part about being king. That's why the Pope and I have dedicated our lives to spreading Christianity throughout the entire world, even if that means killing every non-Christian to do it.
Exactly. So I want to join you in your campaign against the Visigoths.
Deny.
But that's not fair. You're taking Louis.
Yes, Louis is the ideal warrior. He is strong and stupid. You, on the other hand, are educated.
And for what? Father, you're dedicated to something. I just want to be dedicated to something too, with all my heart and soul. Something extraordinary. Otherwise, my life won't have any meaning at all.
Oh, you want your life to have meaning?
Yes, I do.
Good. Deny.
But Father.
Deny.
Father, you created an entire kingdom out of nothing. And now I want my chance. My chance to fight for my country, for my family, and for my king.
Oh, all right. Get yourself a decent helmet and come along.
I'm a soldier.
Yes, you are.
Finally, a chance to do something important. A chance to use my sword, my arm, maybe even my blood.
Gentlemen, be seated. Map. Now, this is the main factor.
Ha! Visigoths!
Yes, battle against the Visigoths is the terrain. So look at this map. Study.
Father, since we're braver and stronger than they are, and have God on our side, why don't we just go out there and slaughter them?
Pippin, war is a science which a general must use, with stratagems and strategies, statistical analyses, to know how many soldiers he's prepared to lose!
Yeah!
Now, gentlemen, this is a plan for tomorrow's skirmish. The army of the enemy is stationed on the hill, so we've got to draw them down here where they're easier to kill. So you in the ravine, that's the area on green, we'll move into the plain where you plainly can be seen. Then the enemy of blue will undoubtedly pursue, and we'll hope to keep your losses to comparatively few! And then...
And
gentlemen, and
then the men go marching out to the fray, conquering the enemy, carrying the dead, heart of blood pounding in our ears, jubilant!
Sit down immediately! Now, where was I? Oh, yes. A general sense of war is hell or even worse. He must never be too cautious, nor too casualty averse. I'm certain the majority of blood they will splatter will be there, so the minimum of damage that's collateral. But we know for success, we must always pay a price. That's why for my success, you must sacrifice. And then... Gentlemen,
and then the men go marching out to the fray, conquering.
Ah! Sorry, Father, it won't happen again.
Well, now time's short. I'll have to speed the whole damn thing up. Listen to me, man, as I endeavor to explain what separates a charlatan from a charlemagne. A ruin under generals, a illustrious Severus, a poppy as a poppy, daring as a Darius. A little rule every leader knows by heart. It's smarter to be lucky than it's lucky to be smart. And then, gentlemen. Now, Pippin, now! Time.
You're going to be very proud of me once again, Father.
I will try not to disgrace you, sir.
Follow me.
War!
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 Yes, you and Pippin did very well. Well, now we rape and sack.
No.
Oh yes, it's required. And singing is essential to victory. Pippin, you're not going yet. False human. Let us give thanks to God for granting us this glorious victory.
I guess it's a little late to wonder who this man was.
It's a little late. But as long as you're interested, I'm just a common man. A Visigoth, but a good man. A very good man.
You're also a very lucky man. You've had the privilege of dying for your king.
Absolutely. Word fail.
You know, of course, dying in battle like this, they'll be going straight to Valhalla, or wherever you infidels go.
Well, absolutely. Your king is the surest person. But this waiting around's got me edgy.
This wasn't your first battle, was it?
No, my third.
Well, then maybe you can tell me. How did this battle compare to your other two?
Well, unless you get killed, one battle's pretty much the same as another.
I was afraid you'd say that.
Pippin, where are you?
I hope you get to Valhalla soon.
Hope you get to heaven.
Oh, I will.
Pippin, a celebration, my own son not joining in. How embarrassing.
Sorry, Father. We'll have to get used to victory celebrations without me. I thought there'd be more plumes.
Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can go free.
Well, I'll tell you the story of a sorrowful lad. He had everything he wanted, didn't want what he had. He had wealth and health and name and fame and all that noise. But he didn't have none of those simple joys. His life seemed purposeless and flat. Aren't you glad you don't feel like that? So he ran from all the genie down, he ran from things that just begun. He ran from himself, which was mighty but a run. Out into the country where he played as a boy. He had to find his some simple joy. He wanted some place warm and green. We all could use a change of scene. Since summer evenings, hot, white, and red, sharing your supper. Why not go ahead? And wouldn't you rather be electrically a crab on the slab at the bottom of the sea than a man who never learns how to be free, not till he's cold and dead? And wouldn't you rather be electrically a crab on the slab? The bottom of the sea, or a noose on the roots of a banyan tree, than a man who never learns how to be free, not till the day he dies. Sweet summer evenings, sapphire skies, feasting your belly, feasting your eyes. Simple joys have a simple voice, and since time is living's prize, and rather be a left-handed queen, a crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea, a new on a root of a bending tree, or a pig on a twig in Galilee. The man who never learns how to be free, not till the day he
living in the countryside.
I can walk by myself.
Warm, strong.
Still attractive.
Very attractive.
Charlemagne's mother. exiled from the court due to a personality conflict with her daughter-in-law, Fastrada.
Grandma!
I hate needle point. Ah!
But you're so good at it.
Pippin? Pippin! Oh, how good it is to see you and to hold you like I used to.
Grandma, you look great.
No, I don't. I look terrible.
No, you look great.
No, I don't. I look terrible.
All right, fine. You look terrible.
Is that any way to talk to your grandma?
Oh.
But actually, Pippin, you look terrible. You need some fresh air, some good food, some hanky-panky.
I don't know what I need.
Well, I know what I need. Some good juicy gossip. You gotta tell me what's going on at court. Is Fastrada still leading your father around by the nose?
Grandma, you haven't changed a bit.
But you have, Pippin. What have you been doing with yourself?
Well, I went to war.
That explains it.
I tried to own my own manhood, you know? Give my blood back. I wanted to do something important, something meaningful. But that wasn't it. Now, I just feel empty and vacant. So, I think I need a plan. Yes, that's it. A goal and a plan. Well, I have a goal. I want to be fulfilled. But a good plan, that's what I've been thinking about. You can't just go rushing into whatever comes along and hope for the best. But on the other hand, you can't sit around wasting time and expect something to just
you lost me in the middle there, Pippin. You need to stop thinking so much. That's your problem. You think too much. You need to learn to live in the moment. Look at this day. Look at it. The sun is shining, the air is warm, and maybe tonight, down at the tavern, there's that lovely young girl you could hook up with and do those things you kids do, and then come back and tell me everything in graphic detail.
Grandma, I don't have time for that.
Time? Now you listen to me, Pippin. I'm an expert on time. When you are as old as I, my dear, and I hope that you never are, you will woefully wonder why, my dear, through your cataracts and catarrh, you could squander away or sequester a drop of a precious year. For when your best days are yester, the rest are twice as dear. What good is a field on a fine summer's night if you sit all alone with the weeds? Or a succulent pear if with each juicy bite you spit out your teeth with the seeds. Before it's too late, stop trying to wait for fortune and fate you'll secure of. For there's one thing to be sure of, mate, there's nothing to be sure of. Oh, it's time to start living, time to take a little from this world we're given. Time to take time, the spring will turn to fall, in just no time at all.
But Grandma, it's time that I'm worried about.
Now you sit down, and don't say anything until I'm finished. I've got three more choruses to do. You can join in with me if you wish. And that goes for all of you out there in the wings too. And all of you out there, just staring at me, looking dumbfounded. But just the choruses, the verses are all mine. I never wondered if I was afraid when there was a challenge to take. And I never thought about how much I weighed when there was still one piece of cake. Maybe it's meant the hours I spent feeling broken and bent and unwell, but there's still no cure, so heaven sent as a chance to raise some hell. Everybody! Oh, it's time to start living, time to take a little from the world we're given, time to take time, the spring will turn to fall, in just no time at all. Verse! Sages 12.
make you feel more obsolete than being noted for your morals. Give me a man who is handsome and strong, someone who's stalwart and steady. Give me a night that's romantic and long, then give me a month to get ready. Now I could waylay some aging away and persuade him to play some granny. But it's hard to believe I'm being led astray by a man who calls me granny. All right, and this time, let's hear it from everybody. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a little from the world we're given. Time to take time, the spring will turn to fall in just no time at all.
So when the drearies do attack and the siege of the sads begins, I throw these regal shoulders back and lift these noble chins. Here is a secret I never have told. Maybe you'll understand why. I believe if I refuse to grow old, I can stay young till I die. Now I've known the fears of 66 years. I've had troubles and tears by the score, but the only thing I trade them for is 67
to Pippin. Oh, it's time to keep living, time to keep taking from this world you're given. You are my time, so I'll throw off my shawl.
Right. It's time for me to start living. Maybe that's the secret to life. Just live in the moment. Enjoy the simple things. The fresh air, the cool, clean water, the fresh fruit off of the... Oh. Yes. And women.
Sex presented pastorally.
Of course. Women.
If I could share my days with you,
my eyes are longer than my hopes. You'll see some stars and smoke them blue.
When nights were far beyond them, if I could share my love.
Fulfilling. Look,
you just got started. There is lots of things you can try.
Like what?
Like taking a look at this.
Peasants revolt, king slaves thousands. Peasants protesting a rise in taxes were slaughtered yesterday by Charlemagne's soldiers. But this can't be true.
Now, would a newspaper print anything that was not true?
My father would never slaughter people just for protesting.
Well, why not? He's the king. Charlemagne today has given orders that non-believers be given the choice between baptism and beheading.
Wait a minute. Forcing people to believe? Telling them what to think? Something has got to be done about this.
You are absolutely right.
I'm finally beginning to see what my father really is. He forces people to fight and die over land that doesn't even belong to them.
He does.
Well, I think that this has got to stop.
It has got to stop!
It's time for a change!
Damn it, it is time for a change!
You know, it doesn't matter that he's my father. We can't just sit around and wait for someone else to take action. Otherwise, one day we'll look around and ask, what happened? What happened is we failed to act!
Down with arms! Down with arms! Down with arms! Down with arms! Down with arms!
Son is disloyal to their father at one time or another, my lady.
But Louis loves you, my lord.
Louis is an asshole, my lady.
Despite this rejection, I took upon my tiny shoulders the task of effecting a rapprochement between two men for whom I felt deeply. Back in my younger days, if things were going wrong, I might sulk, I might pout. Now I've learned if I just pitch in and do what's right, things will always work out. And if we all could spread a little sunshine, oh good. will you be praying at Arles next month?
No, I don't think so, my lady.
Oh, but my lord, you always feel so much better after a yearly prayer.
I do?
Yes, you do. I sought out Pippin. Your father loves you, Pippin.
Freedom and dignity for all men is more important than the love between one father and one son.
Still, your name will be on his lips when he prays. At Arles, next month. Alone.
Alone?
And unguarded.
What date?
The 15th. Oh, Pippin, I beg you to bring this estrangement to an end.
I intend to.
Shall I tell your father of this resolve?
No. Let it be a surprise.
Surprise? I love surprises.
Mama, if Pippin kills father...
He'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
But if father discovers Pippin's blood, executes him.
He'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
Mama, no matter what happens, I'll move up.
Yes, darling. I know the parables told in the holy book. I keep close on my shelf. God's wisdom teaches me, when I help others, I'm really helping myself. And if we all could spread a little sunshine, all could light a little fire, we all would be a little closer.
Right.
Say
goodbye,
father. Goodbye, my lord. Oh, my events move so quickly, it's hard for a simple woman like me to keep up. But something tells me that soon I'll be able to say what every mother wants to say. My son, the king.
I'm here to be with you for one moment, to look into your eyes.
And what do you see?
I see two eyes, a little cloudy with age, a sunset.
What else?
I see the death of thousands, the slavery of more, terror and bloodshed.
You see all that in my eyes?
Do you deny it?
Deny it? I'm proud of it. I brought order out of chaos. If terror and bloodshed were necessary to achieve that order, so be it.
Those are the words from the past. Time has passed you by, my son.
And your time has come, my son?
Yes, father.
It's so easy from where you stand to judge the things I've done. Eagles, ospreys, even vultures have had better view. From the heights, all things seem very clear. But when I marched, the dust of the road was in my mouth. When I fought, the blood of the enemy was in my eye. And by God, I took my breath. And I blew it across the continent. And I shaped an empire with it.
Father, maybe you did the best you could. But things have to change.
And you're the one to change them?
Yes, I am.
Well, if you truly believe that, there's only one thing you can do.
thank you. I brought my own.
Then use it, or go, and leave me to my prayers.
What you pray for, Father?
Strength, and may God...
Why won't my hand stop shaking when all the earth is still? When ancient ghosts are waking, so many steps need taking, so many plans need making. I think I will.
Your Majesty.
King Pippin.
Your Majesty.
Your Highness.
King Pippin. Morning call, morning call. Starts to pepper when you know. Change your set to glow and sleep this fall and gloom. Morning glow is long past doom. Morning glow, build the earth, come and shine. At the birth of birthday, looking through. Morning glow is long past due.
Oh,
all be dealt with fairly. My invitation extends to high and low alike.
Sire, I am a poor man.
You may stand. You may all stand.
Thank you, sire. I am a poor man, a peasant. I do not own 1 millimeter of land on which I have worked so hard my entire life. I ask you, is that fair?
No, that's completely unfair. But I will do something about it. I hereby decree that from now on, all peasants shall own the land they cultivate.
Yeah!
King Pippin the Just.
Sire, if you give our land to the peasants, we loyal nobles have no source of income. Therefore, we can no longer pay taxes.
Well then, I abolish taxes.
Yeah!
King Pippin the Generous.
But, sire, without taxes, you really don't have the money to support an army.
That's all right. I don't need an army. That's it. No more taxes, no more army.
Yeah!
King Pippin the Peaceful.
Hey, Pippin! Sire, it is my duty to inform you that the infidel hunt has attacked in the east. They've destroyed 3 of your villages and murdered thousands of your royal subjects.
Oh, no!
Can he do that?
But he will withdraw on one condition.
Well, that's very reasonable. What's the condition?
He demands your reproductive organs on a pike staff.
Oh. Well, in that case, you'll just have to go out and destroy the infidel.
But, sire, we don't have an army.
Oh, good point. Excuse me a moment. Noble, remember that decree we made a little while back ago about land and taxes?
Yes, sire.
That's all.
But sire, without land, I have neither money nor power over the peasants.
Oh, right. Peasant.
Yes, sire.
I hereby suspend land reform.
Suspend land reform? You mean give it back?
Yes, give it back.
Of thine, sire.
Take that man away and hang him.
Not again.
Wait, no, stop. Could you just let me think for a moment, please?
Darling, you're a born ruler. You're doing a wonderful job. Nothing has changed since your father died. Now about my royal allowance.
Denied. 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 Denied.
King Pippin the Unpopular.
I need to pray.
Pray? What on earth would you pray for? You're the king.
Strength.
Well, is there anything else you'd lack?
Yeah. I'd like my knife back.
You want it? You've got it. Illusion, fantasy to study.
Sorry, Father.
That's all right, Pippin. Don't let it happen again.
Well, that didn't turn out the way I thought it would. And I still haven't done anything fulfilling with my life.
But you will, Pippin. You will. You may not realize it now, but things are going exactly according to plan.
They are?
You look frenzied, you look frazzled, picked as any owl, flushed and rushed and frazzled as a dry damp your scalp. Now I can see you're in a rut. I'm not one to butt in, but in fact.
saw.
Keep cool as custard.
Burn on.
Step inside. There's no trick to staying sensible. Despite each call, the sector seems felt indispensable when you're on the right track.
Budget cuts.
The youths are the first to go.
So he dedicated himself to the church, religious life. He longed to be touched by an angel. But what he soon found was...
it wasn't an angel.
Many, when things get blank, will feel their grip. Oh, we stay. Tranquil spirits high, pulses long.
Lingering on,
lingering on.
I'll never find it. Never, never, never.
Easy, baby. We will just do it again. Enter Catherine. A lovely young widow. A lovely widow.
When I first saw Pippin, he was lying by the side of the road. He didn't know where he was, and he looked so exhausted and lost. The man had clearly lost the will to live, so the first thing I had to do was get him interested in something. Something to restore his faith in life. Something like me. So I said, pick him up, put him to bed, say that he's bathing and fed. You may ask, how could I foretell? I'm sure there are many things you'd like to know about me, aren't there?
No.
Good. My name is Catherine. I'm a widow. I have a son. I own this estate.
I'm your average, ordinary kind of woman.
understand if I not your kind of woman. Anyone can make one terrible mistake, and then no special glamour, no face I can't wear, for I'm just plain, everyday commonplace, come what may, average, ordinary, wonderful girl.
God, what a challenge! I was determined to somehow pierce that dedicated apathy. Now I found that no man, no matter his condition, can resist the charm of a growing boy. So I sent my son Theo to him.
Enter Theo. A lovable boy and his lovable duck.
Pippin. Pippin! Say hello to my duck.
How do you do?
Guess his name.
Augustus?
Wrong. His name is Otto. You know, you're not very smart.
I'm smart enough to know that a duck belongs in the pond and not in my bed. For me!
Pippin, you've been lying in this bed for 7 days now. What is the matter with you?
It's nothing you could possibly understand.
Well, try me. Give me a chance.
Right. I have been searching and searching for something important and fulfilling to do with my life. And I've tried everything I can think of, and I haven't even come close. So I'm in utter, abject, complete despair.
And that's it?
Yes, that's it.
Pippin, let me tell you something about despair. I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then one day, he was struck by fever. And when his hand went cold in mine, I felt my life too was over. I fell into the deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days, but on the sixth, I got up. There were things to be done, an estate to run, a boy to raise. Pippin, this is such a large estate, and I'm all alone here. And I can't do all this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
Hold it, hold it.
You are supposed to read the line naggingly.
But he put his hand on my face. They don't usually do that.
I do not care where he put his hand. Read it naggingly. Listen, you are almost too old to be playing this role, so you better watch it.
I've got my eye on you.
Pippin, this is such a large estate. I'm all alone here, and I can't do all this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
All right. Anything to shut you up.
Well, Pippin was finally out of bed and working. And slowly, he became a part of everything. Part of our everyday lives.
How often do we do this?
Every day.
Every day?
Uh-huh.
Every day. That's exciting.
At first, Pippin didn't show much enthusiasm for the work, but as time went on, he showed no enthusiasm at all.
Keep up the good work, man. What? What are you looking at?
Nothing! Oh, Pippin, there is something. The roof on the chicken house has sprung a leak. If you could get that tomorrow, and the chimney needs bricks, and the field needs plowing, and, well, pigs tie as well. A sty. Thank you.
I know that look. That's the look of a widow with a son and a large estate and nobody to sit at the head of the table. But that's not me. You hear me? That's not me. Patching the roof and patching the hay is not my idea of the next day. When you're extraordinary, gotta do extraordinary things. I'm not the time. Over the size of the cup of tea. When you're extraordinary, could say was, how could you tell? Whoa! You cannot lie, deep in our guts, we give you a beautiful sunshine pot. It's unnecessary for someone who is hairy. Extraordinary hot meat. If the floorboards are squeaky and the doorboards are leaking and the chimneys need a repair, if the garden has pebbles in the yard and some shambles, well, I'm terrified, but I don't care. I've got to be someone who lives. That's too bad, Theo. I'm sorry.
Pippin, this is the first time he's come to you for help.
Could you look at him?
Theo, I don't know a thing about ducks.
Please, Pippin, try.
All right, let me have a look at him.
Now, say something hopeful.
This is a very sick duck. I'm sorry, Theo, there's nothing I can do for him. Wait, Theo, come and kneel down here next to me.
It was like a painting, man and boy and duck at prayer.
His breath has ebbed, his pulse is low, his feet are wept, but even so, you must know that although our tears are poised to burst, we kept our faith warm through the worst. We haven't cursed our luck, our brother luck. To prayer be stuck. Please reward our
luck.
And save this dog.
They prayed all day, and then just after sunset, the duck died.
I'm sorry, Theo. Wait a minute. We could just go to the pond and get another duck. Why does the goddamn duck have to die?
And then an interesting thing happened. Theo plunged himself into monumental despair, while Pippin, that prince of despair, dedicated himself to raising the boy's spirit.
Hey, Theo, we're going out to thresh some grain, and we need another good man. Another time, maybe?
But Pippin showed remarkable persistence. When one thing failed, he tried another.
Hey, Theo, look what I made for you. Listen to this. If you want, I can teach you how to play. Oh.
Well, at this point, most men would have failed. But with amazing perseverance, Pippin tried yet another way.
Hey, Theo, you are not going to believe what I got for you. Okay, when I count to three, you can turn around and look. One, two, three. agree.
That's not a duck, dumbass!
Wait, did you say it was a duck? Go on, you're a flump. No, no, it was my fault.
No, it's my fault. It's been a long time for me.
You know, I think...
Yes?
It'll be better.
Next time?
Next time.
Really happens a little bit of this, a little bit of that, a whole lot of that, but the seasons change, as they always do, and the days were filled with everyday things. Seeds to be sown, fences to be mended, and finally, a love song to be sung.
Sitting on the floor and talking till dawn.
Candles and confidences.
Trading old beliefs and humming old songs.
And lowering all defenses.
Singing love songs.
La 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 la.
Love songs. La 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 la. Five little chirps and silly pat games.
Lavender soaps and lotions. Let me say something then. In the year that you've been with us, a lot of water has flowed under the dam.
Over the dam. Water flows over the dam.
I know, I'm sorry, I seem to be a bit confused.
I can see that. Try sticking to the part, huh?
I will. In the year that you've been with us, a lot of water has flowed over the dam. You've come to mean a great deal to me, to us, to our very ordinary lives. But I would just like to say for me and for Theo, we're glad you're here. And now we have so many good years ahead of us. Sit here at the head of the table. Well, isn't anybody going to eat my pudding?
I am.
I can't stay here.
Pippin!
I'm sorry, I've got to go.
Why?
Because life has cost me more than ducks that die and leaking roofs and flaming quince pudding.
Sure.
And I'm not going to be stuck here doing the same damn thing every day!
And night!
Don't you see? There has to be something more than this! There has to be.
Maybe there isn't.
I know there is.
I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then one day he was struck by fever. And when his hand went cold in mine, I felt my life too was over. I fell into the deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days from the sick. I got up. There were things to be done, an estate to run and a boy to raise. Could you hold the lights, please, for a minute? Thank you. I guess I'll miss the man. Explain it if you can. His face was far from fine.
What are you doing?
But still I'll miss his face and wonder if he is missing mine.
You do not have a song here.
I do now. Some days he wouldn't say a pleasant word all day. Some days he'd scowl and curse. But there were other days when he was really even worse.
I really think you should stop singing now.
Some men are heroes.
Try now. Hello? Where are you? Hello? Come on! You said that there'd be something, something completely fulfilling. Well, isn't there? Isn't there? I still have to believe there has to be something.
Finale.
The finale.
That's it. That's the finale.
Oh no, Pippin. That was just the build-up. You're the finale.
Me?
No! No!
You will leap from the highest heights into the hottest fire.
You will become part of the fire.
Be engulfed by the fire.
Become fire itself, and in that flame, a glorious synthesis of life and death.
And life again.
Wait a minute. You want me to jump and burn in fire?
Pippin, you are an extraordinary human being with extraordinary aspirations and dreams. You deserve an extraordinary climax. Like the sun.
Blazing in the sky.
The sun at its zenith. Think about the sun. Then think about her golden glance. How she lights the world up with. Now it's your chance. With the guardians of splendor inviting you to dance. Pippin, think about the sun. Pippin, it's time for you to do something truly extraordinary.
Think how you'll shine.
Light the glow of morning.
You will burn in our memories forever.
Forever. Think about your life, then.
There's a time and I the same.
Think about the beauty in one perfect flame. And the angels of the morning calling out your name. Pippin, think about.
Rushes to touch. I want
wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much. Everything comes my love. We nearly came in. Never was there. I think it was here.
All right. You'll see what it's like without us. Take down the tent. You heard me, I want it out. Take down the canvas. Strike the rick. Colored lights out. Pinks, reds out. Oh, well, that's not too flattering now, is it, Pippin? Costumes. Get the costumes. And their makeup. Take it off. Look around, Pippin.
He showed me crimson, gold, and lavender, shining away.
Man, there's a mole on her face! Do you want to spend the rest of your life with a woman with a mole?
But there's no color I can have on her. Thou won't find it there.
Oh, no! The king! The king! Do you know how much he's going to cost?
It must be.
Is this the way you want to live?
Costumes to wear.
No makeup.
It was me.
No colored lights.
Cause it never was there.
And no magic.
Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize for our inability to bring you the finale we promised. It seems our extraordinary young man has elected to compromise his aspirations, but I know that there are many of you out there, extraordinary people, exceptional people, who would gladly trade your ordinary lives for the chance to do one perfect act, our grand finale, and we will always be there for you. Whenever you need us, why, we are right inside your heads, and we promise you, sets, lights, costumes, magic. It's over. The show is over. Everybody out. You heard me. Move it! Get out of here! Take out the rest of the lights. Orchestra, pack up your instruments. Let's go. Take your hands off the keyboard! You try singing without music, sweetheart.
I wanted magic shows and miracles. Rushes to touch. Wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much. Never came close, my love. We nearly came near. It never was there. It always was here.
I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner. Oh,